हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द रसेल साउंडर कपलिंग स्कीम। दिस स्कीम इज आल्सो नोन एज एलएस कपलिंग स्कीम। इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस स्कीम, वी विल फर्स्टली कम टू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम। एज वी नो, इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम देयर इज अ न्यूक्लियस एट द सेंटर एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन मूव्स अराउंड दिस न्यूक्लियस इन वेरियस सब शेल्स। सो अ इलेक्ट्रॉन मूविंग around the nucleus in shell will have a definite angular momentum, and this angular momentum is known as orbital angular momentum, and it is denoted by L. Next is, the electron also spin around its own axis, and this spinning makes the electron like a magnet, a small magnet, and this angular momentum is known as spin angular momentum, and it is denoted by S. This is the case of one electron atom, but when there are more than one electrons in an atom, there will be different orbital angular momentum and different spin angular momentum for different electrons. So the condition becomes very complex, and there will be the coupling of this orbital and spin angular momentum, and this coupling is known as LS coupling. As a result of this, we get a new angular momentum that is known as resultant angular momentum or total angular momentum. It is denoted by J. So the state of an atom or the energy of an atom is denoted by certain term symbols. This term symbol looks like this. In this structure, there is 2s plus 1 at the top and J at the lower side, and in the middle it is L. This 2s plus 1 shows the multiplicity of state, J shows the resultant angular momentum, and L shows total orbital angular momentum. This L is denoted by different letters. These letters are S, P, D and F, and this shows the subshells that are 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now, how we determine this resultant angular momentum and this term symbol? For this, there are three conditions. Firstly, we will determine the resultant orbital angular momentum. How we will determine it? It is done by the vectorial combination of different angular momentum. That is given by L is equal to L plus 1, L1 plus L2, L1 plus L2 minus 1, and so on until L1 minus L2. We can consider it by example. We will take the example of P2 state. In this state, the L1 will be 1 and L2 will be 1. So L will be get 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 minus 1 and 1 minus 1. So L will be get 2, 1 and 0. And these states are shown by D, P and S. Now the second step is to determine the resultant spin angular momentum. This is also done by the vectorial combination of different spin angular momentum. So it will be S is equal to S1 plus S2, S1 plus S2 minus 1, and so on until S1 minus S2. We will consider it also by example of P2 state. In P2 state, there are two electrons, and these two will have different spins. So the spin quantum number for one will be plus half and for another will be minus half. So its vectorial combination will be half plus half, half plus half minus one, and half minus half. So we will get two spin states, one and zero. Now the third step, we will determine the total angular momentum or J. It is given by the vectorial combination of L and S. So what we will get? J is equal to L plus S minus 1, L plus S minus 2, and so on until L minus S. For example, we will consider the case of carbon, which has 6 electrons. And these electrons are 2 in 1s orbital, 2 in 2s orbital, and 2 in 2p orbital. Now 2p is the outermost shell, and in it there are two electrons, one in px orbital and one in py orbital. For both, the L value is 1 and 0. The S value is plus half and plus half. So the L we will get 1 plus 0 is equal to 1, and S we will get half plus half is equal to 1. So for J, we will get two values, 1 and 0. So its term symbol we will get, the multiplicity will be 2s plus 1 will be 3. And J value will be 1 and 0. And L will be 1 will be P. So we get two states, 3P1 and 3P0. Out of which lowest state is 3P0. There are certain rules that determines that what will be the ground state term. First rule is the lowest energy term will be 1 with the highest multiplicity. It means 1 in that there are maximum number of electrons of same spin. For example, if we have 3 states 2p, 1p and 3p, out of which 3p has the highest multiplicity. So it will be the ground state, ground energy state. And the next rule is, if there are more than one term of same multiplicity, then the term with the largest value of L will be the ground state term. For example, if we have two states 2P and 2D, both have the same multiplicity 2, but P has the L value 1 and D has the L value 2. So 2D will be the ground state. The next rule is, for half-filled and less than half-filled terms, ground state term is 1 with the lowest G value. For example, in the C6 state, there are 2 electrons in P orbital. So it is less than half-filled. For this state, there are 2 states, 3P1 and 3P0, out of which lower one, that is 3P0, will be the ground state term.